Greetings, everyone.
Hello, Shemai.
How be thee? He is Mikey.
And he is the key man.
We forgot who we were for now. And today, ladies and gentlemen, it is World Hat Day. So we are with you on World Hat Day today, and we are talking about your collections. Do you collect anything? Anything weird? Anything wacky? Anything wonderful? Tell us about it. Text in. What's the number, Mike?
07391.
71.
59.
71. Check it out. Mikey, do you collect anything at the moment?
Cars, modest minus.
Yeah?
I got two, man.
How'd you get into that? How did that happen?
I don't know, I just bought one, I think, one day, and then I just bought another one in.
So you've got two?
So I got two! Yeah.
Hell of a collection, son. Hell of a collection.
When does a collection become a collection?
That's
when you've got more than one, isn't it?
I suppose that's right, yeah.
Well, if you get like five, but that in like cars, that's an obsession, isn't it?
I'd say, yeah, definitely.
That's a divorce, isn't it?
Yeah, it could be. Big time. I mean, cars aren't a cheap collection either, you know?
No.
I've collected some stuff in my time.
What have you got, mate?
Basically, I used to go shoplifting every Saturday.
Did you?
In a store in Merthyr, which is no longer there.
The Bridgesmiths.
We've not heard the names.
Oh, there's...
Other stores are also available. So one Smith soon, you know, it weren't Smith, let's just say it weren't Smith.
Well, can't
and it was a friend of mine that done it.
Would be bankrupt.
So, there's still Mr. Smith
because of you.
Because of me, yeah. Well, basically what I do, I go in every week, right? Yeah. I go in, and I was only a kid at the time, right? So I can't really get in trouble for that, right? I was a kid.
Yeah.
I go in, start reading a WWE magazine, or WWF magazine as it was then. Walk to the door reading it. Walk out the door reading it. Walk down the street reading it. Pass the fruit and veg market reading it. And then have a quick look around, make sure no one was watching me. And then I just chuck in my pocket, job done. Happy days.
That's mad, that is.
Yeah, and I'd done that.
Yeah.
I had probably, about 300 in total. I collect them from the age of 11 to the age of 19. I started paying for them as I got older then, as I became an adult, I started buying them. They were £1.95 a piece at the time they were. But I had a load of them. Literally, my bed broke, so I started stashing the magazines under my bed, and the WWE magazines were supporting my bed, and the it seeped in, it was like a concave, it was. But the WWF magazines then, they fixed the bed, and worked as an aid for that.
That's bonkers, isn't
it? It was good. Yeah. We've had a text as well.
Are we?
Yeah.
Off who?
It's nothing to do with this week's topic of conversation,
right.
But it's to do with last week's. I should read it now, it came in yesterday.
Was it anonymous, or?
It is anonymous, but it does name an individual. So
That's good.
We like it's in relation to last week's, which was based on practical jokes, basically.
Yeah.
World Hat Day, by the way, so we'll do a little swap for a moment. Okay. Let's try that. Cool. I don't know.
I'm a cigar, then.
But it's a no-smoking premises.
All right.
Right, Tex says, all right, boys, how about making your mate drink a pint of P... on the head, and let them think it's warm wine. The person who drank it was Adrian.
Adrian who?
Am I allowed to name him?
Yeah, of
Adrian
course.
Devereaux.
Hey,
lives over there.
Adrian.
Devereaux. Warm wine or pee? You decide, my friend. It's all good. But it's probably... Have you ever drank that?
No.
Yep. That's what you think.
What warm wine?
Well, or pee. In fact, you just spent me a drink. Oh. Is this warm wine?
I don't know.
Or squash? Oh, happy days. Oh, guys, we are live anyway today. We are we're asking for your texts. If you want to text in, text in. If you want us to give you a call, we will give you a call. The number is 07391
39.
Try 71.
71, 59.
71. Can't get a staff these days, can you? Can't get a staff. Another thing I used to collect, and it used to drive my mother and father potty.
Yeah.
I used to collect the little stickers off fruits.
Oh yeah,
I did.
Oh, like the apples in it.
Yeah,
oh, that's
awesome.
Cool.
I had loads of different ones. I did. I used to stick them on the fridge in the house.
Yeah.
And every so often, my mother and father would sabotage my collection cleaning the fridge and what have you.
Like that.
So I just have to up the stakes of the game then.
Oh,
I'd go around the shops purchasing fruit. My dad, all right. Purchasing fruit, or just taking the stickers off and sticking them to my wallet, and then taking them home, sticking them to the fridge. But I had about 40 of them all together.
Yeah.
It became an obsession in the end. I did the little stickers off fruits. You know, it's I wonder how much they would be worth now if I still had them. Text in, guys, if you know. 40 stickers off various different fruits. We're talking pineapples. We're even talking boxes of tomatoes, because they're fruits, not vegetables, by the way. We are talking bananas. Bananas I am. Oranges, tangerines, apples.
Can I tell you a fact about the stickers on fruit?
You can.
They're all edible.
Are they?
Yeah. They're completely edible.
Why'd you say that?
Because I know it. I know that it's true.
That was a ridiculous fact.
It's a very true fact.
But it is a fact.
It is a fact, yeah.
Excellent. Okay, well, that's good. Marvellous. Yeah. Blooming marvellous, you would say. We've got a guest on the show today. A
special guest.
On World Hat Day. We're going to invite him in now. Some of you may know him as Shirley the Bouncer. Some of you may know him as Thomas Bassey the Wrestler. Some of you may know him as Anthony Thomas, the now local historian. So bring him in. Never mind messing with that camera over there, son. This is our show, not yours. Come in. Round of applause. Hey. Our first live guest on the show, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up.
Like that.
How are you doing, my man? Take a seat. Come and have a quick chin with you, bud.
You have any cigars?
Okay.
Like a
As you're aware, it is World Hat Day, so just to get you involved, we'd like you, if you'd be so kind, to wear this sombrero
over the.
For the you can take that off if you want. If you're too warm, mate. Yeah,
it's very warm.
And I'll try this one on. So it's World Hat Day, ladies and gentlemen. If you've got a hat, chuck it on your head. It's that simple. That's what World Hat Day is all about. But we are talking about collections today, so. Yeah. What am I calling you? Am I calling you Anthony? Am I calling you Tony? Am I calling you Shirley? Am I calling you Bassman?
Yeah, call me whatever.
Am I calling you Tuts? Let's go for Tuts. Right then.
Tuts.
Little kiss for you, first of all, right?
I'm just going to state the fact, I still think this is part of your show last week.
No.
It's not.
Not at all.
It's a new topic.
No, genuinely, we do like a bit of humour. Yeah, yeah. We like a laugh and a joke, obviously.
I'm coming to talk about my collection, and I got a... Yeah,
it's a good look at
Frank Spence. It looks like something of a... a policeman.
Who's a hat? I don't know what any of us look like today. It was one of them nights last night. But we'd like to talk to you about your collection, Joe. First of all, Tuts. We'd like to talk to you seriously about your collection. What you collect, how it came about, when you got involved in it. Just give us the story.
I've always collected, so I've always been a bit of an order. Mm-hmm. Exactly the same as yourself. Yeah. Wrestling magazines.
Absolutely.
Videotapes, anything to do with wrestling.
That's right.
Big Prince fan growing up.
Oh, yeah.
Spent thousands and thousands.
And this is the same, she loved Prince.
Collected every record, tape, that was that. So still got them, so that's worth a bit of money.
Yeah.
For the last 10 years, it's basically been metal detecting finds and stuff around Murphy.
How'd you get into that? What prompted you?
Well, my uncle took me when I was young. And took me around and we finding coins. I just had a buzz for it. And then Juggy got me back into it about 10 years ago, talking about it. And then just went from there, bought a metal detector, went out, hooked instantly. So, and then it just went from there. And the more you find stuff, you're looking for the, you know, the bigger thing, you're looking for the gold and the treasure.
Have you found any gold?
No, well, I found a gold ring, a couple of gold rings, but. No gold coins or nothing.
Modern gold rings or old stuff?
Yeah, but 100 years old.
Is it?
Rings, like, I haven't got them with me today. I mean, you said to bring a few things.
Which
I got behind.
Show us what you got. Tell us about it. Where'd you find them?
I got a few objects I found around Murphy.
Oh, jeez, you're not going to chop us up now, are you?
I know. All this stuff's in my kitchen. My old back kitchen is all my collections. My missus goes nuts.
I was going to say, what does Anne-Marie think about this?
Oh, she goes nuts, right? But I cut the kitchen off and put a partition there. So it's my room, right? But I won't throw nothing away. Whatever I find, I keep it. Because it could be, it could be valuable. But, so we got a few finds. I know this is not valuable.
Wow,
but
that's cool, though.
So, I mean,
how old do you reckon that is?
It's about 100 years old, but it's a little kettle. These are just a few strange objects. I found, you know, our horseshoes, but...
That's bigger than that, isn't it?
Jeez.
It depends, mate.
I just pop one down there, right? When we've had a look at that.
I mean, something for you, pair, like beer barrels.
Oh, no, we're talking, sir.
You know, bit like that, like.
So that's cool, isn't it? Where did you find this one?
On Stick Red. Maybe there was an old pub there somewhere.
Yeah, it probably was.
And again, I mean,
what's that? A spike gun, is it?
Well, I like the figures of World War One popping out again, but it is a spike.
Yeah. I used to have one like this. I used to have a red one just like it.
It's nice to play. I mean, you're not throwing it away. I don't know why I'm taking it, but.
Well, why not?
Yeah. That, I don't even know what it is. Like I said, I'm just showing you.
Yeah.
I won't throw nothing away.
Where was this found and how deep down was this sort of thing?
It's a Mercedes sign, is it?
I must have 20,000 objects I got.
Yeah.
Different stuff. I didn't know what half of them is. This one, possible sword. Could probably be just a bit of iron, but.
Well.
Who knows?
Who knows? How's he get this?
Know what I mean? But.
That's cool.
What else we got here? World War One bayonet.
Oh, so look at that.
Another legit.
Am I allowed to hold that? Do you trust me?
No.
Come here, mate.
Have we got insurance?
Yeah, we've got.
Sign no disclaimer.
We've got liability. Don't tell a man. Don't tell a man. No disclaimers on you. You just have to say to the camera, and say it now, please. Whatever goes, goes. Whatever goes, goes. Good man. Right. That's it.
What the
Whoa! Well, that's like an injection thing.
Yeah. Put up cows' asses. Or sheep or something. It was a nice little fight. I mean, you got a maker's name on it.
Yeah, you never know when you're going to need that, right, Charles?
You don't know how to do it. I don't want silver, but.
Yeah.
I'm sure they had some nice. Crowds, dentists in the Guinness.
Ah, yeah. It is, yeah.
I don't even know what it is. I said, this is. This one, I had this.
Wow.
I had this a month
That's
ago.
Cool.
Yeah. It's no jokes. I did find this a month ago on a Metatech in Raleigh in Gloucester Way, I think it was.
Yeah.
And the signal lacked, you know what I mean? But why are you keeping it? I don't know what I mean. But I do keep it in my car, in the boot.
Just in case, is it?
I just keep it in the car. I'm not saying what reasons, but I found it in the
So what's, do you know this Metatech in Raleigh was? It just all you start off being aligned to the Metatechers and then you off what? You go like that?
Yeah, basically you pay your money, you go to a new permission or most permissions are probably done already.
Yeah.
I think it'd be 50 to 100 of you, pay your money. They say, right in our field, that field, bump off your ball. And then
it's great, that, isn't it?
Just get a day in and just all go around like. See some good stuff, Bronzy's axe has been found there in his rallies, like.
Do you ever sell any of your finds or do you keep them all?
I never sold nothing of my finds. I am going to sell a Bronzy's axe. There's a little girl from Urfa with leukemia. And I have got a rare Bronzy's axe I found. It's 4,000 years old. And I'm going to put that on eBay and give the money to him as well.
Good man.
Because a couple of the boys from our Metatech club, it's one of the boys, Justin's niece.
Yeah.
And, so they're all going to start selling their finds.
Mm.
So if I decide to sell any more of my stuff, I will, like.
That's good.
Like,
you do it first.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah, this.
It's like
an
arrow or something.
Well, the rhino's attached to a thing. I mean, it's from a battle, it is. It's about 1500. We found a load of musket balls next to it.
Yeah.
So we found what we should think is a battle. And this, we showed the museum man and he said that would have gone on something.
That's awesome.
And as they come over the top, then.
Push.
Good night.
Love that.
But there, that's just a few strange ones.
That's good, man.
So just to think that's not my collection.
That's just a small part of it.
All the coins we found in the house and all.
Awesome. Do you collect anything else? Or is it just the metal detecting or what have you now? Are you still hoarding?
Well, I just hoarding the metal detector. I said I should have taken pictures to show you from my kitchen on. And it's out the back as well. Yeah. Like the plastic boxes, the guys out the back, and I just want to throw up in it.
That's awesome. Why not? Yeah. Guys, if you want to text in, if you want to ask Tutsu a question as well, feel free. I know it's very quiet on the text today. I know there's a lot of hangovers out there. 2 years for starters. I saw you last night. I hope I wasn't too much of a pest. I was all right for once. It's World Hat Day, guys. We're having a good time. Mikey, what have you got to say on that?
Text in, guys, 07391 71 59 71.
You've got to text
in any time you want.
That's the pie.
Nice.
I didn't see how we're coming. That's not
phone. Save it from.
It's a pen. Bye, Fizz. World Heartache. Guys. Keep talking and show. I'm going to get you a towel, mate. Right? However, you did just say a moment ago to the camera. We've got viewers out there watching, all right? What goes, goes, all right?
Been up to much lately.
I'm snorting like a bull now. I can feel it coming out. Just for the record, everyone's going to think it's a setup. I'm telling you 100%. I didn't know how it was going to happen. I know he's a Packers joker. You've had him so many times with Packers. I've had him as well.
Come here, buddy.
I can't breathe.
But it's shaving foam, it's not cream.
So when he's in his dream, I started tasting it. I can hear him go, just on the record, go back to Packers Horse and we'll get you back.
Yes!
I know you are. I know you are.
And are
I
you a Packers fan? I didn't have a tweet.
I was telling
you. He was in on it. He was the instigator, he was.
Can I go and have a fag and leave you pen?
Go and have a fag. We're wrapping up now.
What's just not flapping?
Hey, round the post. Thank you for coming on, buddy. We'll have a chat to you in a bit. What else do you collect? Do you collect anything else?
I collect practical
joke notches. There's another one on my practical joke pen post.
I think me and him are going to start collecting bruises now.
That was really risky. Did you notice I backed the hell off as soon as I did? Cut the pie and then back right off. You know? Nah, he's a good guy. He always takes in good spirits. Fair play. Ever since our wrestling days. Great guy, one of the good ones, and quite an extraordinary collection. Fair play. He's got a new group coming out as well, which hopefully you'll come in and talk to us about. Yeah. What's your new group called, Shel? What's your new group called? He's not answering. On Facebook, Roman Murphy Tidville, he tells me. He's just having
Murphy
a wash right now.
Murphy
Tidville Metal Detecting Club as well.
Check them out
on Facebook, guys. Seriously, it's a great thing to get into, all right? Get involved. It's good to get outdoors and what have you. He's found some magnificent finds. It's just something he kind of got into.
Yeah.
Off the cuff, I don't think it was planned or anything. He just kind of grabbed himself a metal detector.
Yeah, I see the attraction towards it.
It is interesting, especially when you find stuff like this. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? That's pretty much awesome.
Great stuff,
But collections. I collect sunglasses. I've normally got a pair of sunglasses on my head, right?
Yeah.
Reason being, I got a girl here. And it acts as an Alice band for me.
So it's like an A band?
Well, an Alice band sort of thing, yeah.
What's an Alice band?
Alice. Shh. PG show. I got about 30 pairs of sunglasses at the moment. I buy about 5 or 6 pairs a year.
Yeah.
I lose about 4 or 5 pairs a year.
Yeah.
So I've probably lost more than I've got.
So if you've been collecting them for 15 years, theoretically, because you're still getting one every year because you're losing 4 and you buy 5.
I don't know, that's mathematical, and I'm very hungover.
When is 15 years?
Basically though, I buy sunglasses to match my boxer shorts, my socks, my shoes and my t-shirts.
Yeah.
You know? So World Hat Day. Can we just take the hat off a sec? There's no such thing as World Hat Day, by the way, either.
we just
made that up, right? no such thing as World Hat Day, but there is now, all right? So what's the date today? Do we know the date?
It's the 20, hang on, bear with me.
Guys, text in the date today. 07391 71 59 71. What's the date today?
We've got a text through my phone.
Oh yeah, what have we got?
It's from... Sat 18th of March.
Mark that down in your calendars, ladies and gentlemen.
World Hat Day.
The 18th of March, every year, World Hat Day. So, cool. We're going to wrap it up, guys. So, here's Mikey. Yeah.
And he's been the Cayman.
Now, one more thing to say to you. Get lost.
Get lost. I'll come back, yeah. I love you.